I'm Ellie Cattell, 21 years of age from the Sunshine Coast, also known as Billy the Kid. I'm following around with Fred Brophy's Outback Boxing Trip. It's quite a long way, like most people travelling here. I think it was near 2,000 k's we travelled to get out here. Came out the four-wheel drive, hit the dirt road and had some fun.
Welcome to Birdsville.
Fred Brophy's a showman. He's been doing it for a long time. Us against them, and blokes get up and put their hand up, and next thing you know, Fred's beating the drum, and we just have a crack and do our best, you know. A fella, Berkey by his name, up in Birdsville, surely enough, he put his hand up and said, yeah, I want to have a crack. He had a crew of troops there who were there to support him and look after him. And we got matched up. Billy the Kid against Berkey, you know, and he come up to me, he goes, listen, Billy, it's something I want to tick off my bucket list. I'm not too sure about fighting, but I want to have a crack, you know. And I said, Berkey, I said, there's plenty of blokes who say that and they come in swinging hard, you know, so we'll have a good tough fight, but we'll have some fun. So Berkey walked away with a couple of shiners. Next thing you know, he's sending the photos through to his family and friends, and he walked away with a good experience.
It started a long time ago. My dad used to tell me about the boxing tents when he was a kid, and listen to songs about it, Paul Kelly and Midnight Oil, and watch the Brophy doco. So I just decided, you know what, they're banning it everywhere. That's something I want to be part of. So I just decided I'd come out here and give it a go. I knew that, you know, it's a show as much as a real thing. Got to say, last night, some of those other blokes, it was a lot more real than I had anticipated. Got out there wasn't that much nerves, you know, it wasn't too bad, much less than I thought there'd be. It was worth it 1,000 times over. I mean, you know, I've arrived in Birdsville after this massive trek, you know, are we going to get through the river crossings and they've closed the roads, and yeah, we make it and we finally get here and I get in there and do it. And so on night one, I've done what I came here to do. Billy the Kid, who I fought, was absolutely perfect. I made it known from the start that I can't fight. I'm not doing this because I can fight. I'm doing this for the experience. He looked after me. He gave me a few taps. He was generous enough to let me get a few punches in. You know, he's dusted me up a little bit here, but you know what? That didn't hurt. Doesn't hurt today. The ribs there are a bit ticklish, but worth it 1,000 times over.
He wasn't too sure about it. It wasn't until he got here that he found out about the boxing troop, but you know, he stood up on the podium, he put his hand up.
So I'm Julian Wallet. I'm from France, from exactly in Burgundy. I arrived in Australia like 2 months ago now, so as a working holiday. When I saw the tent, I was with my friends, and he was like, oh, come on, that's so cool. There is a big tent with some boxer. I think that could be, it could be really, really nice to fight them. But he said, oh, come on, they're doing that like every day and for a living. So, but whatever, so let's do it. Could be very funny. Yeah, so with my friend, we said, okay, let's training for a week, 2 weeks. And after that, let's just having fun and just do it. And we'll see. Yeah, I want to fight and I want to stay three rounds and keep stand.
What are you, a Frenchman? Where do you come from? France. Bonjour. Okay, you want to have a fight? You know where you are. Well, you get up here, you're not fighting the shield, get up here.
So I said, oh wow, okay, let's do it right now. Okay, let's go. But I was a little bit nervous, wow, let's go, because I'm skinny. So, and I said, I don't care, I want to fight, that's it. And and that's what happens. I won't die anyway. I won't die, so I just want to do it. In the beginning, they made fun of a little bit fun of me, but after that, everyone said, oh, "You did it. You did well. It was good." And there are some people that bought some beer for me, so it was so great. And a lot of people now, "Oh, good, Julian. Good job. Good job." So I felt really good, and I was like very proud of myself because I did it. That's it. Yeah, and I stayed straight round, so I was really, really good. Proud of me.
I haven't had a fight for 35 years, you know. That was back when I was 13. And that's for good reason, because fighting's stupid. You know what? I feel like if I can't talk my way out of some sort of situation like that, I'm not really trying. I'm good at talking. I'm clearly not good at fighting.
Yeah, I'm keen to find my place in this world. I'm hoping it's somewhere more than a stinking building site, but here we are in the middle of Birdsville. I don't think I'd ever have another opportunity to get out of here if it wasn't for the tent. So, no, I'm looking forward to what's next and enjoy my time with the tent.